Hello, this is Jim Lindsay. This is a real short video to show you how to log into the SAM website for the first time. I want to introduce you to a character I'm going to use for this demonstration. This is somebody that you might recognize from the books or the movie, the TV shows Game of Thrones, but let me introduce you to a guy named Samwell Tarly. Okay, this is Samwell, and he's a guy that he's one of my favorite characters, and if you've ever read the books or seen the show, he's this great big dude, but he's kind of wimpy, and he's very smart, and so he wins a lot of battles basically with just his wits, and so despite his size, he uses his brain to win battles, and so I'm going to make an account for my friend here, Samwell Tarly. And Samwell has a WKU email address similar to one that you might have. So let's say Samwell's email address is samwell.tarly999@wku.edu or at topper.wku.edu. Well, I have to create a username for him in the SAM website, and I'm going to do that. I'm going to do that for you. As your teacher, I will create your account. Now, what is your account going to look like? It's going to look like this. Hold on one second. Okay, I've added the top ringer because I don't want to confuse you. I want your email at Western looks like this. And your username at the SAM website is going to be like this. Basically, take whatever's in the front of the at symbol, and on the end of it, you're going to add cis.wku. That's not a real email address, but it's in the format of an email address, and that's what's required of me when I create an account for you. And so in order to know what your username is, that's the scheme that I'm going to use. So take the first part of your email address, whatever's before the at symbol, and you put that over here, and you just put at cis.wku, and your password is the word please, please. Now the first time you log in, you're going to use this username and this password, and then the website is going to prompt you, say, hey, welcome to the website, agree to our license agreement, and now you have to change your password. And so the very first time you log in, it's going to be this right here, and then you get to create your own password. So let's do that. So how do we do that? Well, we're going to go to the SAM website, which is sam.cengage.com. It looks like this. And in a second, I'm going to jump over to the SAM website and actually create or log in for the first time for Samwell. He has not logged in yet. And then show you how to progress from there. But basically, go to this website in your browser, and then we'll see what happens. Okay, I'm in a browser. I'm using Firefox. You could use Internet Explorer or Chrome or Safari or whatever browser you want. It doesn't matter. I'm going to use Firefox. I'm going to log in again, pretending I'm Samwell Tarly here. So Samwell Tarly 999 at, like I said, cis.wku. And again, yours is going to be whatever the first part of your email address is at this cis.wku. Your password is going to be the word please, all lowercase, please. And then you hit login. It's going to say, get that out of the way, it's going to say, hey, here are the terms and conditions to use our site, and you have to agree to it. You agree to it, and then it lets you choose a secret question. Basically, if you forget your password, here are a bunch of things that you could potentially answer, and then it would turn around and email you the what your password is, or help you reset it. When I create your account, I'm putting your real WKU email address as the communication email address, so this works. And so pick an answer, pick a question, and then type an answer to this that is accurate. And then from there, you'll be able to use the site. So let me do this for Samwell. I'm going to pick one of these, type an answer, and hit submit, and I'll meet you at the next screen. Okay, I chose a question and gave it an answer, hit submit. It took me to this screen where I get to type in the password, and I'm going to type in a password here. And hit submit. And then it shows me, ta-da, here's my stuff. And so as I look at my activity list here, well, let's see. Okay, sorry about that. I forgot to put Sam into a section when I created his account, so I did that on the back side, and now this is what you see. So you do the things we've just done, and then when you get logged in, this is the welcome screen. And basically, it's the activity calendar. You'll see that you're part of a section. Samwell is in my class right here, CIS 141 for Jim Lindsay. This will work the same for CIS 243, for CIS, you know, all the sections of CIS 141. You know, if you look, click on that little arrow, there's only going to be, you know, a class. That's where you are. When you look at the activity list, these are the different activities or projects that your instructor wants you to complete. And there are other videos that will teach you how to do all of that. The purpose of this one was just to teach you how to create your account, get logged in, change that password, and then get to this, you know, this welcome screen here. And again, from the welcome screen, typically we recommend you go to the activity list and then see the things that your teacher has for you to do. So thanks for watching. I hope that this will be a helpful video for you. Have a good day.